Hi, everybody. Welcome to Geekend. This is for the weekend of July 12th through the 14th, 2013. Joining me, as always, is Phil Johnson, Associate Online Editor at ITworld.com. Phil, how was your 4th of July?
Seems like a long time ago. I think it was pretty good, but that's already faded. It was hot. I remember that. Hot and sweaty.
It must have been really good if you don't remember a lot of the things. Did you barbecue?
We barbecued on the weekend, not on the actual July 4th. It was so hot. We were just trying to, like, you know, not melt. We were at my in-laws, and there's no air conditioning, so.
I know. The weather for the last week or so up in the New England area has been really kind of hot, muggy, and my house is like a kiln. I could actually make ceramic pots, I think, inside just my living room.
Oh, wow. Nice.
Yeah,
so steamy 4th of July then.
Well, yeah, because we don't have central air, so we have like room air conditioners, but we keep those in the bedrooms. But then like the living room and the dining room and the kitchen, and then you don't want to cook. It's just it's not too good. This weekend, I guess it's going to be drier, so that'll be good. We ended up doing a pool party and a whole bunch of other stuff. I actually want to give a shout out to the people that helped create the term Geekend in terms of where I stole it from. So I was at their party, and what they do is they were actually at a Geekend. And what they call Geekend is when they gather to play role-playing games and Dungeons & Dragons. They've been doing this since they've been in college, and so every time they have one of these events, they call it a Geekend.
That sounds pretty Geekend-ish.
It is. So a shout-out to Jason and Chris and Kathy and all those other people if they're ever watching this. We're trying to get viewers one person at a time, right?
Right. Exactly.
All right, so let's jump into stuff for this weekend. Let's start with the movies. There are two movies that have sort of a geeky, techie feel to it. The first one is called Pacific Rim. Have you heard much about this movie, Phil?
I haven't heard a lot about it, but I've seen the trailer.
Yeah.
It looks like pretty robot-heavy action, a lot of big robots fighting.
Yeah, at first it had this kind of aliens coming to invade the planet, and we fight back. But it turns out that these aliens are not from outer space, that they're from underwater, so they have kind of a Godzilla feel to it, like they're giant dinosaurs. But in order to fight these guys, we don't just fight them with planes and guns and tanks. We build these giant mega robots. It sounds like, you know, somebody's Asian fantasy in terms of robots and Transformers and things like that.
That's the vibe I got watching the trailer.
Yeah.
Godzilla-like, Japanese-like. Somehow coming out of the water, these big creatures. Yeah, look kind of crazy.
I think this is geared towards kind of that 8 to 12 year old boy kind of genre or demographic. So you know, I'm sure it'll do a ton of money. I think I'm gonna wait until I hear really what the word of mouth is and the reviews on that.
Oh yeah, I think I'll wait till it's on HBO or on demand or something.
There you go. Another one that's coming out on July 17th, so not this weekend, but next Wednesday, it's called Turbo. It's another animated movie. This one's from DreamWorks. It's about a snail who suddenly gets super speed powers.
Yeah.
And then he decides he wants to race in the real Indy 500, and there's actual He's talking to real people. It's kind of like a mixture of Cars meets, you know, animals and snails. I think I'm going to pass on this one. I've done a lot of animated movies over the last few weeks. You know, I took the kids to see Monsters University and Despicable Me 2. I think I'm going to pass on this one.
I can see going to this one.
Really?
The trailer. Yeah, I saw the trailer in the theater, an early trailer a while ago, and then I watched the full trailer just recently again. Looks pretty good to me. I like the animated stuff. It's got Snoop Dogg in it. You can pretty much stop there for me. I'm in. It's got a character named Skidmark, I think. So it's got all the trappings to me of some high quality entertainment. So I think we might be heading out to see that one.
Excellent. I didn't know you were a Snoop Dogg fan, Phil.
I'm not particularly, but the guy's very entertaining no matter what he does. So particularly when he's acting. So when I see that, that does catch my attention. So.
All right. All right, one quick thing I wanted to bring up in terms of if you skip the movies this week and are heading on Netflix to watch some stuff, The Avengers, last year's like the most awesome superhero movie ever, although it's kind of up there with Dark Knight Rises. I think last summer was great for superhero movies, but The Avengers is now streaming on Netflix, so feel free to just watch it a billion times because that's how good that movie was.
Yeah, I got to say, I wasn't my favorite. I'm not a comic book guy, though, so
yeah.
I mean, here's the thing, because I went and I pulled it up the other night to watch it, and it took me about 15 minutes to realize I'd already watched it once before, and just like, once it came back to me, just like the first time I watched it, I fell asleep. So I think I'm in the minority on that, but it never really grabbed me. But again, I'm not a comic book guy, really, so it wasn't doing it for me.
Yeah, I'm going to have to get you some comic books and get you into this whole comic book geek kind of world that we're in here. In fact, you know, later in the fall, we're going to probably talk about the new S.H.I.E.L.D. TV show, which is what I'm really stoked for on ABC. Oh, okay. We're going to talk about that as well. But let's switch gears a little bit. We are in the middle of summer, and of course, a lot of people are taking summer vacations. And you and I had this really good discussion about kind of geeky summer vacations. Now, talk about kind of what your family did.
Well, our family vacation's coming up. We're going to go to Vancouver. Not particularly geeky. There are a couple of space and science museums you might check out. That's probably the top of the geek factor there. My in-laws, however, just went to England.
Uh-huh.
And my mother-in-law did the Harry Potter, it's the Warner Brothers studio.
Right.
Where you can see all the Harry Potter, a lot of the Harry Potter stuff, sets and scenery and stuff. She was all over that. That's got a pretty high geek factor right there. If you're heading over to England and that's one of your main stops, I'd say that's high up there. But for those Harry Potter fans, they seem to love it. So that's a big one.
Do you think that, in general, that you should kind of create a geeky vacation around it, or plan a regular vacation and then maybe just kind of sprinkle in some geeky things to do while you're on vacation?
I plan for the regular vacation, sprinkle them in, but depends how big. In the Harry Potter case, obviously, there's some people that are pretty into it. So if you're really into it, I can see people actually planning their vacations around it.
Right.
It's not how I would go, but I could see some people doing it for sure.
Yeah. What's the geekiest thing that you've done on vacation, or what the geekiest kind of moments for a vacation?
I think one of the high geek factors on a vacation is if you go to Disney without kids as an adult. And I've done that. It was a long time ago, but I did do that. So that's probably it for me. But anytime you get adults doing that, I think that's a high geek factor right there.
Yeah, I think the geekiest actual amusement park these days isn't Disney. It's Universal Orlando, because they've got the Harry Potter stuff. They've got Shrek. They've got Transformers ride now. So and they've got Jurassic Park. I mean, they've got a bunch of different. If you're into kind of like that sci-fi geeky stuff, especially with comic books and Spider-Man, I mean, they've got. That's a park that you have to go to.
That's a very good point. And I think with Disney, there's a whole subculture or whole culture of Disney geeks.
Right, right.
But they're totally into the Disney thing.
Yeah, that's like their mecca. I mean, that's where they go. That's their pilgrimage, right?
People get married there and honeymoon there and all that kind of stuff. So that's a whole other world. But yeah, Universal Studios, that's a good geek place to go for sure.
Yeah, I think the geekiest thing that I've done recently is when I've been to Las Vegas. Now, obviously, Las Vegas is more about gambling and having fun, and drinking and doing some other kind of things. But there is a place that should appeal to if you're into kind of arcade games or video games or pinball, and it's the Pinball Hall of Fame. It's located in a strip mall off of Tropicana, so it's off the strip for a little bit. It's in this little kind of shopping mall, and you go in there, and they've got all sorts of pinball machines from the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, a bunch of old arcade video games, too. But the great thing about it is that the guy that runs it actually knows how to fix all these machines, and you can play almost every game that's in there.
Wow.
So you go in, you bring like $20 in quarters, or you bring $20 and they've got the machines, and you just spend 2-3 hours just playing pinball. It's wonderful if you ever grew up in an arcade and played a lot of pinball.
Fun, definitely fun. And no slot machines there?
No, thank goodness, because you can get slot machines pretty much anywhere else in Vegas.
Yep, they're not hard to find.
All right, a couple of other things. If you are bored with our suggestions, just and you want to head to something like ITworld, ITworld.com has two great pieces of content that we want to talk about. First off, Phil, you just did a post about kind of futuristic interfaces, right?
Yeah, there's a new website that's promoting themselves as the IMDb of FUIs, fantasy user interfaces or fictional user interfaces. So these are computer interfaces that you see in the movies. So like Minority Report, which is going back a few years already, where Tom Cruise is you know, controlling this computer display with his hands.
Right.
Or Star Trek Into Darkness, they got these fantastic, you know, user interfaces. So there's folks that have built a website where they're gathering information about all these FUIs, the designers, the production companies, screenshots, video clips, and they're sort of putting that all in one place, and you can slice and dice the data in several different ways. So if you're into that, you can go there and you can really get lost for a while poking around that stuff. So it's pretty interesting.
Yeah, the stuff from Iron Man 2 and Iron Man 3 are fantastic looking. I just, you know, do you think that you would ever want to kind of control your computer in the way that a lot of these sci-fi movies are doing?
Sure. Looks pretty cool. It looks cool in the movies, at least. I don't know. I mean, maybe doing a lot of this, you know, all day long, you might get some kind of new carpal tunnel thing. I don't know.
I don't know. I just can't see a bunch of the people in the office. Like, you know, we're all sitting in our offices or our cubes, and then if you walk by and everyone's kind of just going like this.
Yeah, that'd be weird.
You know, and I've used the Kinect, and I've used, you know, in terms of video games and controlling, and it's kind of cool, and I'm looking forward to that Leap Motion device that's going to come out, and that's actually going to create kind of gesture control computing. I don't think it's ever going to look like or feel like what it is in the movies, but I don't know. I think I'd be willing to try it. I love new technology and would love to try it. I'm just not sure if it's ever going to get to that mainstream kind of thing, and everyone would be going, oh, it's not like Iron Man 2 or anything like that.
Hey, you know, if nothing else, it might be a little more exercise for everybody who's sitting on their butts all day, right?
That's true. One other thing I wanted to bring up, I have a slideshow on ITworld.com featuring celebrity cameos in classic video game ads.
Yeah, that is awesome, and I highly recommend everybody check that one out. Really good stuff.
We've got, I think we found Jack Black in a Pitfall commercial when he was a young actor. Bryan Cranston, the guy that's in Breaking Bad, he's in a really small little clip. He's playing this other video game from Atari. And my favorite was Carol Channing, Broadway star, pitching for a blackjack game in Atari. So it's definitely something, if you love kind of that classic arcade game or classic home video game system, you kind of forget that they advertised on TV for, you know, games back then.
That's right. Yeah, it's a real trip down memory lane. So it's I definitely recommend you checking it out.
All right, so we've given you guys a ton of information, a ton of stuff to do this weekend or this Geekend. Any other suggestions, Phil, before we sign off?
You're in the Northeast. Stay cool. That's all I can say.
Stay cool. Stay safe and stay geeky. Right.
Stay geeky. Exactly.
All right. Thanks everybody for watching. We'll see you next week.
Oh, you got fancy magic superpowers?
Yep.